Hello friends, welcome to TechWorld. This is Nipsa again. Today I am with a new video for you that how you can secure your web application by using AWS CloudFront. So there is several points to be followed in this process. The first one is request or import a certificate in AWS Certificate Manager. So if you don't know how to request a certificate by using AWS Certificate Manager, I have already shared a video on this in my earlier video. Can report that. Also, you can import a certificate from a third-party certificate vendor into AWS Certificate Manager. So the second point is create a cloud for distribution for your web application. And the third one is cloud for distribution DNS to our web website domain. Then the last one is we have to test our website by using HTTPS whether it is secured or not. So let's go to our AWS Management Console. I have already signed into my AWS Management Console. Then search for CloudFront. Here you can see CloudFront is there. Click here to go to the CloudFront portal. Okay, here create distribution is there. So before creating a distribution, we need to check. So, but which web application we are creating this distribution? So, I have created a web application, and I have also hosted this web application in my AWS S3 bucket. So, let's go to that bucket. You can see here www.easytoexcel.in. So, just click here to check. So I have already hosted this www.easytoexcel.in. If I just go to the browser and click www.easytoexcel.in. Let's see. Yeah. So my website is website. So here you can see it is not secure. Okay. So today I am gonna make this website secure by using AWS CloudFront. So for this, let's go to our CloudFront management. Then click here, create a distribution for this website. So click here, so our certificate. Then our next point is to create a CloudFront distribution. So here I am the CloudFront distribution. The portal, let's get started. You have to choose web. Click here to get started. Then here, this is the important point in the origin domain name. In our origin domain name, there is a drop down list, but I will suggest please go to your bucket and you can see the endpoint URL for your S3 endpoint. Just copy up to this www.easytoexcel.in until .com. Just copy it. HTTP is not required. Go to your CloudFront and paste it. Okay. So it will automatically fill up all those things, or is an ID or connection address, all those things, and move to the policy. So HTTP and HTTPS, just leave all those things, this is the default value as it is. Leave all those things as it is. Then scroll below, set up one thing here. Here a default CloudFront certificate is there, and custom SSL certificate you can also choose. Please check this one, custom SSL certificate. Please check this one. And click here. Here you can see there is a certificate already I have requested in my certificate manager, so it is showing here in the drop down list. If you don't know how to create a certificate in AWS certificate manager, please follow my previous video tutorial. So I am choosing this one. And alternative domain name you can put here like www.easytoexcel.in. Likewise, you can put your own domain name. And then certificate is imported successfully. Then just leave all those things as it is. Then click here to create a distribution. Okay, so you can see here the status is in progress. It will take 10 to 15 minutes to change the status. I mean, distribution DNS to your website domain. So just go to here. This is your CloudFront distribution DNS name. It should find CloudFront domain name. So for this, just go to your domain manager. I have signed into my domain manager. Then here you can see in the www dot, I have already pointed it to the H3 bucket endpoint URL, because before it was like HTTP, but now I am going to make this URL as HTTPS. So instead of H3 bucket endpoint URL, please edit it. This is my subdomain for easy2excel.in, www.easy2excel.in. So the host is keep it as it is, www. Then instead of H3 bucket endpoint URL, you can see this is the H3 bucket endpoint URL. Here you have to put the cloud fund distribution domain name, because we are going to make this website as secure. So just copy this cloud fund distribution domain name, just copy it and put here in the points to it, then save it. Okay, now our CNAME record is changed to cloud fund distribution dev domain name. Then go to the cloud fund management page. Let's check whether it is, the status is changing now. It is in progress state. It's just the page. Okay, let's check our website whether it is HTTPS or not. Let's check. So HTTPS www.easy2excel.in. Our website is secure. Once the status changed, in progress. Can access our website by using HTTPS. Okay, the site can be reached easily because our cloud fund distribution status is not changed yet. Let's wait a minute, then we'll check our website again. So status changed to deployed. You can see here from in progress to deployed, that means the cloud distribution for this website has been created successfully. So we have already pointed this domain name, cloud fund domain name, in our domain provider. So far so good. Now we have to check our website, which is our last test. Let's refresh this page again and check whether our website is good or not. Yeah, so now you can see your website is secure. The padlock is here, that means your website is secure. So, hope you enjoyed this video. So, if you want to see any other video on AWS, please let me know in the comment box. So, thank you.